Welcome to the residential HydroRite Advanced Water Treatment System installation video. This video is provided for you to better understand HydroRite and how it operates. It is highly recommended that this product be installed by a qualified technician. Operation, maintenance, and troubleshooting will be covered in a separate video. Before beginning installation, make sure to read the HydroRite system manual carefully and completely. These manuals are included with the product. This video is designed to serve as a quick overview, which does not replace or supersede the detailed installation or operation requirements set forth in the owner's manual. Pay close attention to all safety instructions, warnings, and cautions before installing the HydroRite system. For a free copy of the manual, please visit www.hayward.com. Before installing HydroRite UVO3, we first need to balance the pool chemistry. This will increase the effectiveness of the system once installed. The chart on the screen details the levels required. The HydroRite product contains a high-intensity, electrically operated ultraviolet UV lamp, which is located inside the unit's wet chamber. The HydroRite creates ozone, a strong oxidizer and bactericide, along with the UV to oxidize bather waste and inactivate microorganisms utilizing a process known as advanced oxidation. When the HydroRite is creating ozone, bubbles will appear within the HydroRite vessel and may also be seen at the return jets in the pool. At flow rates below 35 gallons per minute, ozone creation will stop and the bubbles will disappear. Although low flow rates will prevent the introduction of ozone, the longer exposure time to UV light within the vessel will increase the potency of the UV sanitization process. Consider these factors when setting run times and pump speeds. Plumbing diameter, 2 inch. Input power, 120 volts AC, 60 hertz. Power consumption, 0.8 amps or 8 tenths of an amp. Maximum operating pressure, 50 pounds per square inch. Operating flow range, 10 to 75 gallons per minute. Minimum flow rate of venturi, necessary for the creation of ozone, 35 gallons per minute. Maximum flow rate, 75 gallons per minute. Number of bulbs, 1. Volume of vessel, 0.75 gallons or 3/4 of a gallon. The HydroRite HYD-UVO is capable of sanitizing residential pools up to 60,000 gallons. For larger installations, more than one HydroRite can be used. When using multiple HydroRites, plumb vessels in parallel. The HydroRite system contains the following components. HydroRite controller. Vessel. 2-inch Venturi manifold. Venturi hose kit with check valves and fittings. Ozone-producing UV lamp. Gloves for handling the UV lamp. 2-inch flow switch. 2-inch three-way valve. Valve actuator. These are the tools needed. Saw or PVC pipe cutter. PVC glue. 6 mounting screws / bolts for fastening HydroRite controller to mounting surface. 4 mounting screws / bolts for fastening HydroRite vessel to mounting surface. Screwdriver / nut driver for mounting fasteners. Phillips head screwdriver for vessel cap. Remove power to the pool filter pump before starting this installation. Installation must be performed in accordance with local and NEC code. The HydroRite vessel must be mounted at least 10 feet from the pool. The controller must be mounted a minimum of 6 feet horizontal distance, or more if local codes require, from the pool and has a 6-foot power cord that must be connected to a GFCI protected circuit. Refer to the diagram on the screen for lengths of all cords and the Venturi tube. Note that the vessel and flow switch may be installed into the return plumbing before or after the heater, but always before any chemical feeder or chlorination system. The controller is designed to mount vertically on a flat surface with the cables facing downward. Because the enclosure also acts as a heat sink, which disperses heat from inside the box, it is important not to block the four sides of the controller. Do not mount the controller inside a panel or tightly enclosed area. After ensuring the controller's cables can reach their destinations, mount the controller to the intended surface using proper mounting hardware given the size and weight of the unit. The controller's mounting brackets require a total of 6 mounting bolts. Although not required, Hayward recommends that the HydroRite system be plumbed in a dedicated loop that can be bypassed as shown on the screen. A 3-way valve and actuator are supplied for this purpose. If plumbing a bypass, a T-fitting will be required. A bypass will also aid in servicing and maintaining the HydroRite. Note that the increased head of the HydroRite system may affect the performance of water features installed in the pool system. A bypass will allow you to divert water directly to water features when high flow rates are required. Note that under these bypass conditions, the HydroRite will not be actively sanitizing the water. Installation of 3-way valves on both the inlet and outlet lines attached to the vessel plumbing is mandatory if an automatic vessel cleaner is used, or if the vessel and associated plumbing is located below the water line. Failure to use valves where any portion of the device is below the water line will not allow the device to be properly drained, which could lead to cracking of the unit if any retained water freezes. When the vessel installation location has been determined, it should be secured to a concrete or wood base. 4 mounting holes are located in the mounting base of the unit that accommodates 1/4-inch diameter bolts to mount the HydroRite unit in place. Failure to secure the unit may cause noise due to vibrations caused by water passing through the wet chamber. Secure the vessel using bolts and anchors, not supplied, where necessary and appropriate for your installation. The HydroRite vessel comes with union nuts and tails pre-assembled on the housing. Remove the inlet and outlet nuts and note the orientation of the orange gaskets when removing union tails. After cutting pipe to length, glue the gray tailpiece to the pipe end. Repeat for the other pipe. Thread the union nuts onto the vessel and hand tighten both unions. Do not over-tighten. Over-tightening will break the union nuts. The flow switch must be plumbed in the same section of plumbing as the vessel. Failure to properly install the flow switch can result in damage to the pool's equipment. There must be at least a 12-inch, 30-centimeter, straight pipe run before the flow switch. To ensure proper operation, verify that the arrow on the flow switch points in the direction of water flow. The Venturi assembly is pre-assembled and ready to be plumbed. A 3-foot hose connection is made from the Venturi to the ozone manifold at the vessel. If using a chlorine erosion feeder or other chemical feeder, install a check valve to isolate the vessel from the feeder, preventing chlorine from backfeeding when the pump is off. For salt chlorinators, a check valve is not necessary because those systems stop producing chlorine when the pump is off. After plumbing is complete, run the filter pump and check for leaks in the HydroRite loop and the bypass loop. Note, do not plug in the electrical power cord until all wiring is complete. To gain access to connectors, remove the 4 screws securing the large vessel cap and remove the cap. Refer to the diagram on the screen for connection locations. Do not touch the UV lamp with your bare hands. Gloves are included with HydroRite and must be used when handling the lamp. There is a single ballast cable from the controller that connects to the UV lamp, packaged separately. This cable must be connected to the lamp before inserting the lamp into the vessel. The lamp has been designed to only fit one way. There are tabs on the lamp that need to be lined up for insertion. After fully seating the lamp into the vessel, twist the lamp/cable clockwise about 1/8 turn to lock it into place. Insert the UV lamp's ozone tube into the back of the ozone manifold as shown. Route the ballast cable through the appropriate cutout. The interlock prevents lamp operation when the cap is removed. The 2-conductor interlock cable attaches to the square connector at the end of the pigtail shown on screen. Find the appropriate cutout and route the wire through. After making all connections and routing the cables through the proper cutouts, replace and fasten the cap. As shown on screen, the flow switch and interlock cables both use an RJ-11 connector that plugs into the bottom of the HydroRite controller. The connectors are not labeled, and either connector can be used. For operation, maintenance, and troubleshooting, a second video is provided. Professional help. For professional help and service, go to Hayward.com and select Dealer Locator, which you will see directly below the Hayward logo and to the right of products. Next, provide the postal code of where the system is installed, as well as 1. Search radius, 2. Pool type, 3. Product repair and service, 4. All Hayward products. Lastly, select Submit, and you will see all local Hayward authorized service centers who can assist with Hayward troubleshooting, maintenance, operation, and service. You may need to enlarge your search radius if you do not receive any results. Continue to visit Hayward Pool Products at www.hayward.com, along with our social media sites for helpful information about your Hayward products.